Hey crew, welcome back, and we're going to continue playing Let's Play The Legend of Zelda, The Minish Cap, and I'm going to turn the music back on. We're still playing the same album, Skillet's Alien Youth album, and right now we're about 2 minutes from the end of Earth Invasion, which is the third song on the list. So, ka-cha! I'm just playing it from where we stopped. Anyway, so welcome back to the fail episode, yay! Where we go in multiple circles looking for the piece that we need. And eating more cactus bread. I feel like this is my old LPs. And I should be recording live, but I'm post-commentating, and that's not where we want to go. Alright, map. Can you tell that I'm, like, devising a plan? I'm like, oh, I need to go up there, but I want to go down there, and I want to go around. So, anyway, I watched Zegjita's stream today. It was pretty cool. Pretty decent. He was streaming, and then he was gone for a little bit, so Crisco Knight was taking over. And then, the chat was pretty much a bunch of people I didn't know. But I guess some people knew who I was, so I was like, okay. And then, like, all of a sudden, like, other people started showing up. Like, ALG showed up, which is A-Lail Gamer. ASDF San showed up. Luka Jin showed up. Maybe We Right to Play showed up. I don't know. But there were a bunch of people in there that I was like, whoa. But there were just other people in there that I had heard of before, and I'm just not subscribed. But it was pretty cool. I was hanging out for a while to wait to see if, Nintendo Capricorn was going to join in, but I wasn't sure if he was, because, he usually posts his videos in the morning, and then, I don't know what he does the rest of the day, but his videos are always, like, up at by, like, 10 in the morning, so, maybe he's just a morning person. Anyway, but yeah, pretty much, not a whole lot's changed. This little tactic I'm trying here is to see if I can dig up the shark, like, out of the clouds. Like, dig him up and then try to punch him. But it didn't go so well. Oh, we changed songs. Hold on. I gotta see what the next song is. You Are My Hope. Song number four. So. Bum, bum, bum. So later on tonight, I'm going to, my friend Brian's house, and we're going to watch Office Space. I'd never seen it before. I heard it's really funny, but, he didn't, like, go and rent it from the movieplex. He just recorded on his DVR from the TV, so, like, all the swearing and, like, nudity or whatever is, like, blipped out or taken out or cut out or whatever. And just for the sake of, like, you know, Christian values, like, Christian morals and purity and stuff, like, I honestly, like, enjoy a good movie, but, like, excessive swearing and, like, too much boobies or whatever is, like, man. You know, it just gets way over the top, and it's like, seriously? Could this movie be any more not PG-13? And, honestly, I think it's because the United States and even other countries have been so desensitized to profanity and sex and nudity and, you know, it's like, man, you know. Here's the last spot that I was looking for, finally. Ugh. So there it is. But, I mean, there's shows on, like, public TV now. One of the shows I'm thinking of is Law & Order SVU, which is Special Victims Unit. And pretty much all the show is it's Law & Order, which if you guys have seen the show, it's pretty cool. I enjoy just straight up Law and Order. I don't actually enjoy SVU or CI. But, like, Law & Order is a really good show because it involves courts and it's really cool. But, I don't know if you guys caught the cut there. I cut from me getting all the way around and on. Anyway, so, and there's another windstone here, so that's, and this is the last warp that we'll get, so there's no more warps after that. But, I mean, I understand that, like, rape is a big thing, and, like, murder and abuse and domestic violence. Like, I understand those are really crucial things in a court system, but to base a show, like, a sub-show off of it, like, it's just not, you know, it's just not my thing. Like, I don't appreciate that, like, it's so, I mean, I understand that they're bringing light towards the subject, but it's not something I would really care to watch an hour of. You know, if I wanted to watch an hour of rape, I mean, or not, it's, okay, I take that back. It's not watching an hour of rape. It's watching people fight over, like, what happened and investigating and finding clues and whatever. And I mean, like, if I want to watch something that, like, reminds me of something gruesome like that, I'll watch Saw. Like, Saw is sick stuff. I mean, it's, ugh. Like, Saw 1 and 2 were pretty good. Actually, Saw 1 and 2 are the best. I'm not going to lie. Saw 1 and 2 are the best. 3 is okay. 4 is ridiculous. And 5 is just completely nonchalant. It's so bad. Alright, so, I got to say something right here. If you remember correctly, way back when we got that teleporter, that teleported ourselves into here, this guy, I think his name is Gregor. Anyway, there was a ghost flying around him, and we got rid of the ghost. And in return, he actually gives us the light arrows. So what you do is you go to use the arrow, and if you hold it down, kind of like when you hold on your sword, the arrow charges up, and then bam, you got a light arrow. It's really good. I don't know how much more powerful they are than regular arrows, but I would assume that they're a little more powerful. I think we switched songs again. Yep. Now we're listening to Eating Me Away. Arrgh. Sounds like a donut's worst nightmare. But the light arrows are, I mean, I like them. They take a lot of the charge, but just having them, like, I think just the fact that it's the light arrow boosts its strength, even if it's 10%. But anyway, if you don't get rid of the ghost, it's okay because you still have regular arrows. It's just that the light arrows are a little perk of the game. Kind of like the mirror shield. Like, you don't have to have the mirror shield, but it's a perk. It's part of the game that you can get after you finish it. So, anyway. But, yeah. But, anyway, back to what I was talking about. Like, with Saw is a good, I mean, the first movie is pretty awesome if you haven't seen it. Like, the first time I saw it, I was geeking out. I was like, whoa, like, the plot was, I would say, is the best plot of the whole series. Differ if you want, but for me, that was the best of the series, I mean, of the 5 that I saw. I didn't go and see Saw 6. I went and saw Saw. Terrible. Anyway, so, but if you've seen the movie already, you know about the ending. And I'm not going to say the ending because I know it's an older movie and people have probably seen it. But if people that haven't seen it, I don't want to ruin the ending for you because the ending literally makes the movie. The ending makes the movie. It blows your mind. Like, you would never think of this would ever happen. So I'm not going to ruin the ending. But Saw 2 was pretty good. 3 was iffy. 4 was, it just started getting ridiculous. And Saw 5, don't even bother. It's a waste. Because really all they do is they try to recycle characters, and no matter how many characters they recycle, you're never going to get around to a complete storyline with characters involved. For people that have seen the movies, one of the worst character linkings I've seen is the husband of the wife from Saw 3 that, has the shotgun collar. You see the husband in the end of Saw 3, and then you don't see him again until Saw 5. And the daughter that was in the cooler, you never even hear about. I don't even know what happened with the daughter that was in the cooler. Honestly, I have no idea, because they never elaborated on it when the movies came out. Oh, by the way, that boomerang shot was pretty epic. I just thought it would be fun to try because I had the magic boomerang. I would try it and see if I could get it. And I did. But, I mean, I'm ranting about Saw, but in all honesty, if you're going to watch a movie, I mean, watch a movie. I mean, movies are movies. They're not realistic. I mean, the only ones that are realistic are obviously documentaries, but it's a movie. I mean, a lot of people are all about censorship in movies, and, like, for me, it's, like, the Christian morals and stuff, but it's a movie. And, you know, and the same thing with TV shows. It's a TV show. But anyway, we're getting short on time, so I'll continue next time on Let's Play Legend of Zelda: The Minish Cap. Bye-bye.